stood up yesterday against the, upon the lathi charge which happened on the students, each and every student who was present there at the Vice Chancellor's lodge. We were there right from the beginning when we entered the Vice Chancellor's office, where few of the students and few of the like-minded professors are already inside, where an executive council meeting was happening in a personal residence of a Vice Chancellor, which is supposed to happen in administration block, and where the students couldn't even protest against the decisions of executive council or academic council or any kind of council meeting which is happening inside the university, where it is termed as the personal residence, but it was used for administrative purpose. And when students were protesting against this kind of brutal, this kind of autocratic nature of this particular administration, and especially this person, Appa Rao, whom we do not consider as Vice Chancellor. I don't want to term him as Vice Chancellor. We, the students of this University of Hyderabad, do not term him as Vice Chancellor, do not consider him as Vice Chancellor. This person who was sitting inside VC's lodge when the police were brutally dragging students, when they were groping students, when they were molesting girl students, when they were giving rape threats to girl students, and when they were brutally lathi charging students of this university, he was sitting inside that VC's lodge without any kind of response, without any shame, that he is the Vice Chancellor of this university and who is supposed to be our guardian when we are away from home. And this person who is supposed to be our guardian is asking the police, is ordering the police for a lathi charge along with this government, this fascist government, who is attacking students of this university, entering this university, where they are not even allowed to enter. This was the situation yesterday. Each and every one, each and every comrade, each and every friend present there showed lot of courage. I cannot even express in words the courage which the students of this university showed. The patience which the students of this university showed against this Appa Rao, who was responsible for the institutional murder of Rohit Vemmula. This person who did not even come to see Rohit Vemmula after he died, who did not even come and talk to the family of Rohit Vemmula. He's sitting in the position of Vice Chancellor of this university. This person who did not even respond to the lathi charge, and who said in on record that police had done their job. This person cannot continue as the Vice Chancellor of this university. And Vipin Srivastava, where you can see in all the pictures, sitting right beside Vice Chancellor, he is one of my professor. He had come to my class one day when USTA was on strike against illegal entry into a professor's house, and also against the police presence inside the campus. This person has come to my class and told all the students to unite against these people. He was telling there are good people, there are good people, and there are the other section of people who for their political motives ruin the careers of the students. And all the other students should unite and fight these students who are protesting. So this was a comment made by a professor inside the class. So you will be able to understand who is behind all these things. When R.P. Sharma was Vice Chancellor, this person came to my class and said all this. So these are the people who are sitting in Executive Council, these are the people who are sitting in Vice Chancellor's office, who care least about the students of this university, where we cannot roam freely, our police presence everywhere. Yesterday these police were saying, you are girls, so you should behave like girls, not like prostitutes. These were the ones who were saying all this inside, when only some 10 girl students were left inside. These were the police who were slapping students inside VC's lodge. They were brutally dragged outside. They were chased even at the departments. This is our university, and it is not the university of police or this Vice Chancellor or anybody. I am not sad today, I am not in grief today, I am very much happy with the courage which is shown by the students of this university. And I hope the students who are in jail along with the professors show the same courage. And it is very important that each and every student of this university should stand with the students who are arrested and also with the professors. The professor K.Y. Ratnam, when he came into the rescue of the students who were in van, he was brutally punched in the face 5 times. We were all there just standing. This was the situation yesterday, so I request each and every one of you to go back and talk to each and every student of this university. Let the university students know what is going on and who is sitting in the position as vice chancellor, who doesn't even care about the lives of students, who made students starve for 2 days without water, without food, without internet connections. And this registrar went on record saying, let us cut electricity for 2 days and let's see how the struggle will stand. Let us show the people in administration block, let us show this vice chancellor, and let us show each and everyone who is trying to disrupt the movement and trying to suppress the struggle that no, you cutting water, cutting food is not going to stop us. Your lattes and your police is not going to stop us. Let us show, let us continue this struggle in a most democratic way possible, and let us show what the students of this university can do for struggle, for justice, for those.